Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Biochemistry Concepts. This video is about what causes and what are the different types of Crigler-Najjar syndrome. So this Crigler-Najjar syndrome is due to complete absence or a marked reduction in the bilirubin conjugation after approximately 120 days in the circulation. The red blood cells are taken up and degraded by the reticuloendothelial system, particularly in the liver and spleen. Out of 100% heme which is degraded to bilirubin, 80% of heme comes from RBCs and 20% from immature RBCs, myoglobin and cytochromes. Bilirubin which is formed is slightly soluble in the plasma and therefore it is transported to the liver by binding non-covalently to the albumin as bilirubin-albumin complex. Bilirubin released from this complex enters into hepatocytes and it binds to an intracellular protein, particularly the protein called as ligandin. In the hepatocytes, the solubility of bilirubin is increased by addition of two molecules of glucuronic acid. Bilirubin is converted into conjugated bilirubin. In this reaction, bilirubin reacts with UDP-Glucuronic acid and this reaction is catalyzed by UDP-Glucuronyl transferase, where this UDP-Glucuronyl transferase enzyme transfers glucuronic acid from UDP-Glucuronic acid to bilirubin. So this forms bilirubin glucuronide. So most of the bilirubin glucuronide formed is bilirubin diglucuronide, means bilirubin with two molecules of glucuronic acid. Some amount, around 15% of conjugated bilirubin is bilirubin monoglucuronide, means bilirubin with one glucuronic acid. This addition of glucuronic acid to bilirubin is known as conjugation. This condition is classified into two types: type 1 and type 2. Type 1 Crigler-Najjar syndrome, it is a rare type and it is inherited as autosomal recessive condition. There is complete absence of UDP-Glucuronyl transferase activity. So the enzyme is completely absent. Jaundice appears within the first 24 hours of birth. Severe unconjugated hyperbilirubinemia is seen. Unconjugated bilirubin increases to more than 20 milligrams per 100 ml. Hence, it results in kernicterus. This disease is often fatal and children die before the age of 2 due to bilirubin-induced neurological damage. Coming to type 2 Crigler-Najjar syndrome, it is a milder form and it is inherited as autosomal dominant condition. Patients with type 2 disease, they have partial deficiency of UDP-Glucuronyl transferase. So there is some amount of enzyme activity seen. Bilirubin level in the blood does not exceed 20 milligrams per deciliter. And the patients, they survive without any neurological complications.